worketh is rewarded, not reckoned of grace, but of death. But to him that worketh not, but believe on him that justifies the ungodly, his faith is counted for righteousness.
6. Abraham was justified. told Abraham where he was going until he got where he wanted Abraham to be. So now that takes a lot of faith to follow this God that you've never seen. But the thing about Abraham was Abraham had a relationship with God. Do you have a relationship with God? Can you go to him and can you talk to him? Anytime you're burdened, anytime you're down, can he be your friend? Is God your friend? So if you have that right relationship with God, and you can go to God, and you know what he says he's going to do, he will do it. You can be justified by your faith.
I can't hold it.
It's what said the scripture, Abraham believed God, and it was counted unto him for righteousness. He believed God, and his sin was banished from him because of that. And guess what? If we believe in God, and we have accepted God, because sometimes we believe and we don't accept. If we accept God, if we accept Jesus Christ in our heart, our sin can be banished away with. When it comes to us and when it comes to Abraham, we are found not guilty because our sins have already been paid for. So Abraham was the ancestor of Israel. He believed in God, and God counted it all for righteousness. Any question on the first part of our lesson? Comment. Okay, receiving righteousness is the second part of our lesson. This part of our lesson is talking about works. It says, now to him that worketh is the reward not reckoned for grace, debt. Okay. I don't know why sometimes I just can't bring up some words. But to him that worketh not, but believeth on him that justified the ungodly, his faith is counted for righteousness. When we work all week, we want a paycheck at the end, right? At the end of the week, right? Okay. If they pay us to work, they don't owe us anything. Because he believed we already been paid. Now, we work for God, and we are not saved by our works. Our works will not save us. Only our faith will save us. And the reward for that is that we gain eternal life. So, all your rewards is not going to be here on earth. So don't look for you to get everything here on earth. If you get everything here on earth, hey, why go to heaven? I got it all here, so why do I want to go to heaven? But we are not going to receive all of our rewards here. We receive righteousness when we believe. We are righteous when we believe and trust in God. Even David, y'all know what David did. Y'all know what David liked. David did something terrible in the sight of God, and God did not like it. But listen to what David said. Even as David also described the blessedness of the man, unto whom God can put righteousness without works. God bless us even when we don't work. We believe in him. But there's one thing I know. If you love the Lord and if you trust God, you are going to do some work. You are going to do something. You're not just going to say, oh, God saved me and that's it. You are going to do something for the Lord. And if you're not doing nothing for God, I think I will check myself. And then you're going to ask me, what kind of work? Do you read the Bible? Do you study your word? Do you pray? Are you faithful to your church? Are you faithful to your family and your friends? Are you doing good things? And now, like I said, works will not save you. All those things and still die and go to heaven. But if you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, if God lives, if the Holy Spirit lives inside of you, you are going to do something. Something for God. Because you're not satisfied. this building for what? Worship.
Worship.
Where does our work begin? When do you go out the door?
World.
So when you, the world, thank you, sir. So when you come to church and you say, well, that's it until next Sunday, that's not work. You're not doing what God wants you. You're not doing what God wants you to do. So if David can talk about forgiveness of sin, David was blessed because David was called a man after God's own heart. And he sinned terribly. But guess what, y'all? God forgave him. Why God forgave him? Because David fell down on his face and asked God to forgive him. There's no sin too big or too great that God will not answer. None that God will not answer. So if you think you did something that's too terrible and I can't go before God, if you have the right relationship, you can ask God for forgiveness. Hey, nobody else can forgive you, so you might as well ask God to forgive you because he's the only one that can forgive you. So receiving righteousness, you do not receive your righteousness by the work that you do, but by the faith that you have in the Lord Jesus Christ. Second part of our lesson. Any comment, any question? Father of the faithful, third part. In this part of our lesson, the Jews always thought that they were better than everybody else because they were the descendants of Abraham and they circumcised themselves to prove that they were faithful to God, and this was a ritual that was done. So they thought that they were better than everybody else. And all of these circumcisions, verse 10 and verse 11. When like I said, the Jews always thought they were better. We do a lot of ritual here in our church. We are baptized. We are confirmed. What else are we? We take the Holy Communion. What else do we do? Those the most important one. The Jews would circumcise themselves. That was their ritual. And they thought they were better than the Gentiles because, you know, they were Abraham's descendant. But they still could be circumcised and still lost because not accepting Christ, not trusting, because Christ hasn't come yet, but not trusting in God. So don't think that the ritual that you do is going to save you. Because Abraham was counted as righteous before circumcision, Paul argued that the patriarch could therefore be the father of any righteous person. Because Abraham was their father, they thought that, well, I'm circumcised, so Abraham, you know, they looked to Abraham as their father. They looked to Abraham as being great, and I'm going to circumcise myself, and then I'll be saved, or I'll be right in the right state of mind for Christ and for God and be righteous. But circumcision was only a tradition. Only a tradition. God didn't love the circumcised no more better than he loved the one that was uncircumcised. The thing that God wanted from us and from the Jews and from the Gentiles and from everybody else to trust him. If we trust him like Abraham trusted him, then we would be okay. We would be in the right state of mind for God. So we are saved by grace. And guess what, y'all? Salvation is a gift. You can't work enough to get it. You can't pray enough to get it. You can't pay enough to get it, because God gives it freely. He's not going to charge me for salvation because he gives it freely. Now, my part in this is accepting and believing it, walking in the faith of God, walking in the path that he would have me to walk. And how do I know where, how do I know the path that he wants me to walk? How do I know that? How do you know the path God wants you to walk?
Through
his word. You can't know what God wants you to do if you don't read his word, if you don't hear his word. The commandments say, do not steal. So I know, well, if I'm following God, and the commandments say, do not steal. If I steal, I sin. But y'all, if I steal, God is right there to forgive me if I ask for it. If I ask for forgiveness. You know, sometimes we think we're too proud to ask, or we're too big to ask God for things. But how are you going to get it if you don't ask? I don't know your condition. I don't know what you stand in need of. So we have to ask God. It was peace in the end. When we study his word, we know what he wants us to do. And when we do what he wants us to do, and we trust him, and we live according to how he wants us to live, then we'll be in the right relationship with our Heavenly Father. But Abraham did what God wanted him to do. Abraham was righteous in the sight of God. And the same way Abraham was righteous in the Son of God, we too can be righteous in the sight of God. I have a few questions here. Any comment, any questions on receiving Father of the Faithful? Abraham was the father of the faithful. And if you want to be faithful, follow in Abraham's footprints. Follow, go the way he went. Because I think we are blessed a little more than him because of what we have. We have the Bible to go by. And could you believe this? It was 2,000 years between Abraham and Jesus. 2,000 years. And God's word was still going on. Somebody was still reading God's word. Somebody was still praying. And the Old Testament, Abraham didn't have that. Abraham even didn't have the law, because the law came after he was gone. The law came when Moses came on the scene. And Abraham was long off the scene when Moses was here. So he didn't even have the law, but he trusted God. He believed God. Okay, one of my questions is, what was Abraham justified by?
Faith.
Abraham was justified by his faith, the faith that he had in the living God. Abraham, I believe this, now the Bible doesn't say this, I believe Abraham and God relationship was so close that they could walk together. Just like God would walk in the garden with Adam, I believe that's the kind of relationship that he had, because Abraham, you have to have a relationship with someone to trust them this much. Okay. Is there any difference between the faith of Abraham's days and the faith we have today?
No.
Why?
Well, often weaker. Favorite anytime you procure your own son, sacrifice that faith. Will you give your son?
That's another lesson. That's another story.
That's a question.
I think today's society, we are saying that we knew that where we came from our four parents. And we can tell from the more God bless us now, it seemed like the ball we stray away. So I'm saying, but faith in God is the same. It's the same faith back then. Our foreparents, they paved the way for us. They made it possible for the ambition that we enjoy now. They began with the PS4 box fan. So they'll be in the way, but and they try to teach us and pray for us that in the future that we can still believe, but we still don't believe a lot of people. What's the same thing? God doesn't change. The same God yesterday, today, and he will be the same God tomorrow. And he doesn't force us. He gives us a choice.
Anybody else? Thank you, sir. What would happen if we were justified by the works that we do? What would happen if I did a lot of good works? What would happen? What would happen if we were justified by our works?
Then would abide. Christ, everything changed. That's why we're blessed. You've got to walk by faith, not by sight. Otherwise, you're blind. You're quite blind to this work.
But if the work that you do, I sing on the choir, I usher, I visit the sick, I do all of this and I do all of that, what would happen if that would get me, I should have said like this, what would happen if I do all these good works? Would it get me into heaven?
No.
Believe and have no believe.
Okay.
Because a lot of time, I mean, you see a person shouting in church. How about their heart? It has to be their heart. You can come inside this building here, and then when you go outside, you're two totally different people. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, that's nice to you.
Anybody else?
If you see my work, you'd be bragging about what I do. Most.
If we have nothing, then nothing can tell me right. If you don't mean it, you go to hell. Man. You got to watch the blood of life.
That's, I would be, my chest would be out to hell. I sit on the choir. Put me down there to pray. I can pray. I can read. You know, and we would do these things because we can do it. And somebody else might not be able to do it. So that's why God is saying, your works will not save you, but you are going to work. And you're going to do it gladly because you know how you got your salvation. It's a gift that came from God, and I didn't have to pay a thing for it. All I had to do was accept it. All I had to do is say, Lord, I accept your son. Accepting Jesus, and you have salvation. Now, you might do some wrong things, but you have salvation. You might go some wrong places, but you still have salvation. The Bible says that whoever, Jesus said this, whoever God gives me, nobody can pluck them out of my hand. And look at David, like we just talked about. Well, how much time have I got? Just watching in the rain. What time is it? 9:30. Okay. David did wrong, but David went and asked God for forgiveness, and God forgave him. David didn't lose his salvation. So don't think that your wrongdoings. Don't think that the things that you did wrong. Don't think that the work that you do. It's going to get you in heaven, and then you're going to lose your salvation. Because salvation is a gift from God through his son, Jesus Christ. One more, and I'll let you. Is our faith strong enough to save us? Or I should say this. Is your faith strong enough to save you? Is your faith strong enough to save you? Is your faith strong enough to save you? It's not a trick question. Ain't nobody
wants it. Saved by grace.
Saved
by grace.
No. Your faith ain't strong enough to save you. You know why? Jesus is the only one that can save. Jesus saved the one with a little bit of faith. Jesus saved the one with a whole lot of faith. Jesus saved those with no faith, but you got to get it. So your faith is not strong enough to save you. Faith, even if you have faith that is weak, Christ is the only one that can save. And what is faith? Faith is trusting and believing in Christ. That's what faith is. It's trusting and believing in Christ.
But we are saved by faith. For by grace are we saved through faith. You get God's grace through faith. If you don't have the faith enough to believe it, you ain't gonna get it. So it is faith. We are saved by faith.
Faith.
By God's grace, but we have to have faith.
Another question I want to ask. Why do you think, and this is not in our list, but why do you think God used the men in the Bible more than he used the women? Or why do you think God didn't tell the women everything? Instead, he went to the man, you know, he went to Abraham and he would talk, you know. Man is the head, man. Look, he didn't say that. Man think more like God. Okay. Now, God made man and women, and he knew a woman's heart.
Right.
And he knew, made us different.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if God had gone to Sarah and said, Sarah, I want you to go sacrifice Isaac, what do you think would happen?
No, Lord.
Sarah would have said, now, wait a minute, Lord, wait now, wait. You take all this time to give me Isaac, then you want me to sacrifice him? That's why he don't tell us everything. Something we got to figure out for ourselves. But he still loves us now. He made us and he knew our heart. You all this time, Abraham, an old man, and I, an old woman, and you give me this child. Abraham couldn't even tell Sarah what he was going to do.
No.
Could you imagine her going to kill Sean and I could sit in the house? No! I'm going to get my baby. That's my, and this is how we say, that's how I say, that's my baby. I know it's his, but that's my baby, and you gonna go kill him. So that's why God don't tell us everything. Let me do my conclusion and we'll be alone. Our prayer for today is, Father, may we live daily as people whose faith result in unconditional trust in you. We have to have unconditional trust in God, like Abraham did. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. And our thought to remember, Lord remain as the Father of the faithful. The Lord remains the Father of the faithful. If you are faithful, God is your Father. That's our lesson for this morning. And we have bereavement in our church family, and we ask you to pray for the McGill family. Anybody else? And all the bereavements in the neighboring community. Please pray for these people. And if you can do anything to be a blessing to them, please do so. And I talked to Norma yesterday, and she's home and she's doing good. She has a way to go, but she's home. The most important thing, she said, I'm home.
Bless God.
So keep praying your prayers. And I can't say call her because speeches, you know. So just keep her in your prayer, and if there's anything you can do for her, just do it for her. So that's our lesson for this morning. And do we have any visitors? So if not, we just thank you for being here, and we pray God's blessing upon all of you.